Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Before starting this video, I would like to ask you a question. So, those who are preparing for SEBI grade A, तैयारी कैसे चल रही है आपकी guys? If you are not preparing for SEBI grade A, then you should start preparing. Those who have filled the form, because the date is just around the corner, you don't have that much time, guys. Start your preparation for the examination, and this series of morning tales is definitely going to help you. And not only for the SEBI guys, this is for RBI and NABARD examination students as well. This series of morning tales is for phase one of RBI, SEBI, NABARD, as well as for other banking examinations. Okay, so I hope that you are preparing well for your examination, and do watch this series regularly because it will help you in remembering Spotlight better, which is the phase one magazine. So now on this note, let's begin our video for today. But before that, subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed yet, and do hit this bell notification to get the instant updates. Telegram bhi join kar sakte ho. Here you can connect with your mentors like me, Mansi ma'am, and Manish sir and Anuj sir. So there are your mentors on this platform. You can connect with us, and the link is in description box below. So here is our first question. Which of the following has become the first court in India to live stream its proceedings on YouTube? So quite a easy, or I guess quite a not to fit question it is. So, but guys, these type of questions are important. They can be asked in the examination. Why? The reason is that nowadays many things are going online, and due to this COVID thing, going online has become a new normal, and that is why you should keep a track of things that are going on in India, especially when it is related to government, court, or any kind of very important agency. So obviously High Court is an important agency. So which High Court has done that? It is Gujarat High Court. Again, so it is Gujarat High Court, and it has become the first court in India to go live stream and to live stream its proceedings on YouTube platform. Bhi yaad rakhna, theek hai? Now your task is to tell me that who is the Chief Justice of this High Court, because we are talking about just Gujarat High Court. So justice bhi bahut important hai pata karna, to wo aapka kaam hai. That is your task. You will tell me that who is the Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court. Next question पे चलते हैं. Which state has launched the Parivartanam scheme to help the fishing community by improving their livelihood skills and enable their social economic upliftment through entrepreneurship? So we have been given the purpose in the question itself. Parivartanam means change. So what is this scheme? What the scheme is going to do? It is going to change the existing situation of fishermen community in Kerala. So the right answer is Kerala. Kerala has launched this scheme, and the purpose is to uplift the socio-economic situation, to improve the socio-economic situation of Kerala's fishing community, as well as provide them enough jobs and skills to create their own entrepreneurship enterprise, to create their own enterprise. So what are the three main purposes of the scheme? First is to improve their social economic situation. Second is to promote entrepreneurship, and third is to generate jobs through skills, to provide training, skill training to the fisher community. So that's all for this scheme. I hope that we are clear till now. Next question is, in which state has India's first solar based integrated multi village water supply project launched? So quite a big phrase it is. Let's break it. The project is this only: integrated multi village water supply project, which is India's first solar based project. So this multi village water supply project has been launched in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. Lower Dibang Valley. So this is the district in which this project will function. This project will operate in this district. A total number of 39 villages will be provided water supply, and that too with the help of solar power. So here this question ends. I hope that you are clear with this question. Do remember that it is Arunachal Pradesh as well as the district that is Lower Dibang Valley. Now guys, in this valley itself, there is a very prominent hydropower project being built. And what is the name of that project? That is your task to find out. Tell me in the comment section below. Next question, which state has extended loan of over 545 million euros, which is rupees 4,767 crores in Indian currency, to the Mumbai Metropolitan Region Development Authority for infrastructure projects in Mumbai? So here, what are the things that you need to remember? First is the amount. Second is the agency that has got the funding. So two things are clear. Now the third thing is, which agency has given this loan? The right answer is KfW. This is a bank in Germany. So this bank has extended a loan for infrastructure power, infrastructure projects. And what kind of infrastructure projects are being built in Mumbai for which this loan has been granted? It is the metro lines. So two metro lines will be developed under this project for which KfW has given the loan. I hope that I am clear till now. In case if you have any kind of problem, you can ask me in the comment section below. This question is important. Who has been appointed as a new Chief Information Commissioner of India? So the straightforward, simple question it is of appointments. So who is that person? It is Yashwardhan Kumar Sinha. Remember his name. He is the new Chief Information Commissioner. And besides him, there were information commissioners. I guess four information commissioners were there who have been appointed along with this man. But you are not required to remember the names of those information commissioners because the major important appointment is of CIC, that is Chief Information Commissioner. So remember that only. That will suffice your exam preparation for phase one. What is the limit of UPI transaction volumes allowed for the third party UPI payment applications according to NPCI? So guys, have you heard about WhatsApp Pay? There are many of you guys who have got WhatsApp Pay facility already. So WhatsApp Pay has been recently launched and WhatsApp Pay does not have any connection with this news as such. But since it was launched yesterday only, that's why I picked it up. So WhatsApp Pay launched hua hai recently and WhatsApp Pay mein UPI payment hoga directly. And this question is also related to UPI transactions. So before that, a few days ago, NPCI has mandated that each third party application like Google, we have Google Pay, Phone Pay, Amazon Pay and PayPal. So these are kind of third party applications that are providing UPI transactions in India. Now NPCI has mandated this thing that each and every company can have only 30% of UPI transactions, can contribute to 30% of total UPI transactions that are going on in Indian market. So what is the limit? It is 30%. Option B is the right answer. Remember this thing. It is important, can be asked in the examination. Therefore, you cannot skip this fact. Now, why has it been done? The reason is to promote Bheem UPI. Bheem is our own UPI system. That is why, in order to promote this, this decision has been taken. And guys, do you know there is one startling fact here? The fact is that both these companies were accounting for 40% of total UPI transactions in Indian market each. So this is a huge quantum. And in order to restrict foreign companies monopoly in this market, or in other terms you can say, in order to promote India's own UPI system, this decision has been taken. And here the number that you have to remember is only 30% and not the 40%. That was just for your information. So 30% is the number. Next question. Which countries conducted the cooperation afloat readiness and training naval exercise? So which countries have conducted it recently? Bangladesh and US. have conducted this. So here I just want to elaborate this thing that you are not required to remember only India's military exercises. You should also pay attention to the military exercises that are conducted by other countries in collaboration with the other countries, basically the foreign countries which are collaborating with each other in order to conduct the military exercises. Now here you have to restrict yourselves to only the major ones. Only remember the major countries' military exercises, like US, Japan, Australia. So these are some of the major countries which conduct military exercises quite often, and therefore you have to remember their military exercises only. And these kinds of exercises are mentioned regularly in Spotlight magazine, so you don't have to look out for other sources. You can download the magazine and have all the military exercises conducted by India as well as by other countries at one place. Okay, so we have discussed everything here. Next is our last question, which is about a book. So who is the author of Jugalbandi, the BJP before Modi? This is a very interesting book from the title itself. Those who are interested can read this book. So who is the writer of this book? The right answer is Vinay Sitapati. So this looks very intriguing. This book looks very intriguing. Now guys, here my session ends. I hope that you have really liked it. And if you have, then do subscribe to this channel and hit a thumbs up on this video. Thank you so much for watching the video. And yes, keep preparing for your examinations. Good luck.